As the family was stunned at a funeral when the casket contained the wrong body. Wrong family member was sent from Fort Worth, Texas. Meanwhile, back in Fort Worth, the body that was supposed to be at this funeral that this family is supposed to see and send off their loved one was cremated, and now the family's suing. Let's take some just get some information behind this, because the defendants in this lawsuit, which was filed in Tarrant County District Court, are the Tarrant County Medical Examiner's Office, the Brown, Owens, and Brumley Family Home Funeral Home, the University of North Texas Health Science Center, and AccuCare Mortuary Services. All four of them are on this list for this horrific mix-up. So here's how this all happened. In March of 2020, Jose Gonzalez, who was 47 years old, drove through Tarrant County as part of his route as a long-haul truck driver. He became suddenly ill and went to a local hospital. That's according to this suit, which was filed in March of this year. He died at the hospital on March 20th of 2020. Gonzalez's wife, Selena Gonzalez, made arrangements with funeral homes in Fort Worth and California, where the family lives. Her husband's body was supposed to be embalmed and transported from a funeral home in Fort Worth to the funeral home in California. So according to this lawsuit, the Tarrant County Medical Examiner's Office switched the bodies of Jose Gonzalez and Jesse Gonzalez. The Medical Examiner's Office gave Jose Gonzalez's body to the UNTHSC and gave Jesse Gonzalez's body to AccuCare Mortuary Services, is what this suit been claims. UNTHSC and AccuCare did not verify that they had the correct bodies, according to the suit. UNTHSC harvested Joe Gonzalez's body for organs and cremated it. Again, they cremated his body as part of the Willed Body Program, where the center cremates bodies that no one has claimed. His body was cremated several weeks before they found it. They found out that it was the wrong one, is what David said. So there's obviously no way to remedy that situation. The suit asked for trial by jury and a minimum of $1 million in damages. So not only one particular entity that screwed this whole thing up, but a second that also didn't double check that they had the correct body, the correct family member that they're supposed to do the correct things with. There's no turning back after you cremate someone's body and also harvest their body for organs. $1 million seems minimal, honestly, to me.
Dude, as somebody who's recently had to deal with the loss of a loved one, back in February, we lost my mom, rest in peace to my mom. There's just so much that happens when somebody passes away that you just don't even know that you have to deal with. Like, there's just like a million things coming at you that you have to deal with in an urgent fashion. And the idea that this type of thing would be piled on top of that, I can't even imagine the devastation and the sadness involved in this. And like you said, $1 million, I mean, I don't even know how you repay these people for this level of hurt. You know, people just like the whole point of this, like post-death stuff is some level of closure. So, you know, we do that stuff for us, the living, right? So that we can move on. It's like, all right, we're doing this thing, we're saying goodbye, but life has to go on. And this is how we do that. This is how we go about doing that. And to rob these folks of that, man, that is just, that is tough. That is terrible.
And again, that's not gonna change. This, as you said, this is for the living. This is for us to continue on and remember something and have something to come back to. Some people want the cremation. Some people want to go and visit a headstone and a grave. Whatever they wanted is just not gonna happen. This is for both families. Let's keep it real.